All right, we're going to review The Master, but first let's take care of some business. Number one, my friends were right. Dread was pretty damn awesome. Go see it. It deserves it. Number two, Looper didn't screen in time for me to review it. The same people who told me Dread was great are telling me this is great. Number three, Hotel Transylvania, actually pretty good. Clever premise, good voice acting, great feature directorial debut by Jenny Tartakovsky. It's got an easygoing, old-fashioned character comedy vibe working that only cuts out when it remembers to try and have a conventional plot. Number four, this is that time of year when horror movies actually start getting a shot at the box office, which means someone is going to try and tell you how great the new anthology film VHS is. Well, it's not. It's really, really not. So, then, The Master. The Master is probably going to end up being Paul Thomas Anderson's least popular movie. Not because it's not good, in fact it's really good, but it's also his smallest, least showy movie. This is one of those ugly truths about a lot of good movies or so-called classics. A lot of the time those storied films that are so good regular audiences and critics and or movie buffs actually agree on them aren't agreed upon for exactly the same reason. Like, Goodfellas is a really good movie, great actors, masterfully directed, etc. Its position as a classic of modern American cinema is unquestionable. However, the reason that movie is in a lot of people's DVD collections is that sick pistol-whipping scene. Or maybe they just superficially dig on the whole macho mob guy fantasy angle, both of which are perfectly fine, by the way. My point is, for a guy who tends to make pretty high-end, big-idea, arthouse sort of movies, Paul Thomas Anderson's filmography is actually pretty popular with mainstream audiences. I mean, Boogie Nights, Magnolia, Punch Drunk Love, There Will Be Blood, those are all widely seen and pretty popular. Even if you haven't seen them, you've probably at least heard of them and maybe one or two big-deal moments from them. That's the thing. Up to this point, Anderson's movies have come front-loaded with those kind of big set-piece moments or water-cooler conversation elements. The lurid porn industry and crime drama stuff in Boogie Nights, Adam Sandler going for grown-up drama in Punch Drunk.
If you have a milkshake, and I have a milkshake, and I have a straw, there it is, that's a straw, you see. Watching. And my straw reaches across the room. And starts to drink your milkshake. I drink your milkshake. I drink it up!
From There Will Be Blood, that ending from Magnolia, etc. The Master, on the other hand, is probably his first movie without any of those kind of scenes. It's not really a showy or visually elaborate movie. It's a fairly straightforward character piece. And while I think it's every bit as good as Blood was, I'd be surprised if it catches on in the same way, which is unfortunate because it's very worth seeing. The film's story is pretty simple, a chronicle of a strange and tragic friendship between two deeply troubled men in the 1950s, Joaquin Phoenix's Freddie Quell and Philip Seymour Hoffman's Lancaster Dodd. Quell is a violent, aggressive, self-destructive alcoholic who finds it difficult to reintegrate into society after returning from his World War II Navy service. Dodd is a would-be Renaissance man, author turned New Age self-help guru, who seems to recognize Quell as a kind of kindred spirit and becomes quietly obsessed with keeping him around under the auspices of curing his various psychological hang-ups, even though his new friend is clearly a danger to himself and others. All of this takes place against the backdrop of Dodd's quixotic transcendental self-help philosophy, The Cause, gradually morphing into something that looks more and more like a cult, perhaps driven more by Amy Adams as Dodd's cold, calculating wife than by Dodd himself. And this is where we get to the elephant in the room. Yes, The Cause looks and acts a lot like the early days of Scientology, and yes, Lancaster Dodd looks and acts a lot like L. Ron Hubbard, but for all the pre-release publicity, The Master really isn't so much a takedown piece that many were predicting or maybe hoping for. Yeah, it gets in its digs, and if you know what they're referencing, you'll probably laugh, but really, The Cause could be a stand-in for just about any similar movement, right down to the way that Dodd seems to end up being trapped by increasingly devoted followers who take his bizarre ideas more seriously than he ever did. In fact, that's kind of the arc of his friendship with Quell. He starts out hoping The Cause can help the guy, but winds up hoping he won't be stuck in it as he's become. The actors are all pretty excellent, but the mercurial Phoenix is the surprising standout. He makes Quell into a fascinating kind of human freak show, alternately frightening or pathetic, and it's probably the best performance he's given up to this point. The movie deserves credit for building so much of its narrative around such a thoroughly unlikable character. It's probably a given that The Master will be up for a bunch of Oscars in a few months, and I definitely recommend people check it out. It's an interesting movie about interesting people and worth a look, even if it's not necessarily something we'll still be talking about years and years from now. See you next time!